private games, tank body customization, and the potential of a new 32 versus 32 game mode. That's what we're talking about in this video today. The first two items are probably things that you're sitting there rolling your eyes at because they've been delayed or they've been coming soon for quite some time now. And then the 32 versus 32 game mode, well, that at least sounded interesting to me, so I thought I should talk about it with you guys. The Pacific is not even 2 weeks old yet, and we are learning more and more about what DICE has in store for us throughout the chapter, and, well, it's got me excited. Okay then, so first of all, private games, or community games, as it's now likely going to be renamed to. First of all, it was called Rental Server Program with Battlefield 1, then it evolved into private games for the announcement with Battlefield 5, and now apparently it's going to be called community games. It's one feature that's had three different names for the same game. Regardless of what the name is actually going to be though, we know the story here. It was omitted from Battlefield 5's launch because DICE had pushed their Tides of War construct extremely hard, and unfortunately, Tides of War is really not to everyone's liking. It relies heavily on first-party rotations, playlists, and matchmaking to function properly, and as I think we all know, that isn't really what Battlefield is known for. A portion of the community, specifically on the PC side of things, they're much more used to opening a server browser, they look for a suitable server, and they end up joining that and having a slightly different experience from the official rule set. Community Games is going to provide players with a free server creation service that will allow them to build their own rotations of maps and game modes, alongside a bunch of modifiers and settings that will create a different flavor of Battlefield when you enter that server. Many communities over the years, they've created their home within the Battlefield franchise by spinning up servers that adapt the official rule set into something that they enjoy even more than that. And my personal hope is that those communities see this feature and then they come back to the game and they give it a shot. The community feeling within the game, the clans and the teams that used to exist, many of those have kind of moved on or they've shut down because of the lack of systems in Battlefield 1 and Battlefield 5, but we might be seeing DICE give us those systems back here with Battlefield 5 now. Community Games does have a date for launch locked in with the development team, but the development team isn't sharing that date publicly right now. According to Adam Freeman on Reddit, we're going to find out that date closer to the date that the system is due to launch on, so it has been confirmed to be part of Chapter 5, we know that already, it's just we still don't actually know what date it's going to launch on. So we're kind of getting closer to it, but it's still a little bit confusing. Wake Island, that is launching in December, and I hardly think that the DICE team wants that map releasing too close to Christmas in case something goes wrong. No one wants to work over Christmas, so I'm hedging my bets on an early December launch for the Wake Island map, and that would also be a near-perfect time to launch community games as well. Okay then, moving on from private games, community games, rental servers, whatever it's called. Next, we want to talk about tank body customization. This is probably the feature that deserves the classic soon TM tag the most in Battlefield 5 because it's been coming soon since the day the game launched. This video is being uploaded on November 10th, 2019. Battlefield 5 launched on November 9th, 2018. That means it's been 366 days since the feature was tagged as coming soon. Who knew that soon meant over 1 year in the future? Besides that massively long wait that we've all had, in a video earlier this week I did report that via a data mine, it's been found that the main menu received some updated code with the 5.0 update that leads us to suspect that tank body customization may finally be making its way into the game, soon. Adam Freeman also mentioned that the feature does also have a targeted launch date, and once we're closer to it, that date will be revealed, just like community games. Now, my one hope with this feature is that we've now been waiting over 1 year for it to arrive, that DICE has actually brought that feature up to date with where the game is right now. I hope we don't see a feature launch for the game where it's over a year behind where it needs to be. It needs to be relevant to the content that's currently being highlighted right now, and that means Pacific-based customization for the US and the Japanese tanks, as well as support for the British and the German tanks that we've been using for the last year. With the Pacific update landing so well for Battlefield 5 and being received really well by the community and bringing in a lot of new players and bringing back players who stopped playing the game, I do have a bit of renewed faith in DICE at the moment, and I'd like to think that despite the huge amount of time that has passed, that the team has been working to make sure this feature is properly fleshed out for its final launch. And then, moving on to this potential 32 versus 32 game mode. Right now, and I do need to warn you, this is not official information, and it's been found as a result of a data mine by Temple Yao, but it did pique my interest, and I think it's worth discussing because it's these larger scale modes that Battlefield is really, really known for. Now, this new mode that's been found is called Invasion, and a description for it reads, "Destroy enemy resources whilst protecting your own. Eliminate enemy troops and resources to win." The mode features two rounds, so likely you're going to play as one faction for the first round, and then it'll be flipped round and you'll play the other faction for the second round. But these resources, based on the information that Temple Yal has uncovered, they sound like they kind of take the place of flags in Conquest. In Conquest, you have to capture flags to bleed down the enemy tickets, and you have to kill enemies to win. If you lose flags, that might swing the ticket bleed in favor of the enemy team, so you need to be attacking flags and defending flags at the same time to win a round. Here in Invasion, it sounds like these resources, they're the main focus of the game mode, and for that, there are several types of resources that you can protect and destroy. So first of all, there is a barracks location, and if you hold on to this location, then you're going to gain the ability to spawn more troops into the battle. There's also a naval resource, which doesn't have a description at this moment in time, and that could well be because naval combat doesn't focus massively in Battlefield 5 at the moment, but that could well be some form of spawning of naval vehicles, like the amphibious tanks, for example, or it could be some type of shelling or artillery that activates for your team if you hold on to it. That is just speculation at this point, however. We don't have any information about what that naval aspect could really be. There's also a tank factory, an airfield, and a radar station that can be captured and held by one of the two teams, and then they can be fought over. The tank factory, that gives your team the ability to spawn tanks into the battle. The airfield, that gives you aerial capability, so probably spawning in planes. And then the radar station, that is going to spot enemy players for you. Could you imagine if you held onto the radar station and it just lit up the entire 32 players on the enemy team? That could be quite interesting, but this setup sort of sounds like some of the older Battlefield games, where if you captured certain conquest flags, you'd actually gain access to features of the match that previously hadn't been active. Battlefield 5 kind of does this in Conquest, where some of the flags give you the ability to spawn an extra tank or an extra plane, but in older Battlefield titles, the flags had a lot more weight because they'd only unlock certain features if you held onto them, and they wouldn't have been active previously in the round, rather than just providing you with an extra spawn of something that is already available. Invasion sort of has that older style feeling, but of course it's not a Conquest game mode, it seems to be its own game mode in its own right. Now, of course, as I said earlier, this is a data mine at the moment, so we can't really say for certain if this game mode is going to make it into the final version of Battlefield 5 or not. It could simply be an early concept for a game mode that is now no longer going to happen. If you look at the different areas that would be available as resources within the Invasion mode, we've got the tank factory, which there is kind of one of those on Iwo Jima within the caves. It's a tank constructing location. We've got the airfield, the top of the default flag on Conquest, that's technically kind of like a radar station or a tower station. You've got the beach landing, so there could easily be a boat out in the water that could shell the ground. So there's possibilities that this fits into the Iwo Jima map, but as I've said, it's a data mine and we don't have any extra information, so right now we can't really say for certain. But there is one final thing that I do want to mention, and it's kind of concerning the Grand Operations game mode. That's active in Battlefield 5 at the moment, and we haven't really seen any new content for Grand Operations since early 2019, I think, with the Battle of Hanu Grand Operation that included the Panzerstorm map. But according to the Battlefield 5 files, there are now references to battalions, and those featured in Battlefield 1's operation structure. So perhaps we're going to see a reintroduction of the older Battlefield 1-style operations into Battlefield 5, or maybe DICE is just looking to update the system to bring back some players towards that game mode. I know Grand Operations is not particularly popular, and Grand Operations just kind of sucks, so maybe it would be better if we went back to something that more people enjoyed. But that, again, is data mined information, so take it with a pinch of salt. So then, it looks like some decent updates for Battlefield 5 will be following the big Pacific content drop over the next few weeks. Update 5.2 for the game, that is scheduled to land in December, and I know there are some decent changes and fixes coming within that patch, but when it comes to content, we know that Wake Island is coming, a brand new map for Battlefield 5, we know more weapons are coming, and we know that soon we're going to have community games up and running, and finally, a proper tank body customization system as well. A big thanks for watching this video today. Make sure you give me your opinions down below on all of this stuff in the comments section. And don't forget to check out the Born to Shill merch as well. Thanks to everyone who's gone over there and checked it out so far, and to the people who've bought something over there. I really appreciate you. bit.ly/Westy Shop. But until next time, my name is Westy, and I'll catch you guys in the next video.